Hi, in the previous video, we looked at how to bring this Mickey Mouse illustration from Figma into Xcode for animation. In this video, we will look at how to use the illustration to create this animation you see over here on LinkedIn. You can find the animation assets in the Figma community. So if you go to the Figma community, you can search for Mickey Mouse illustration as illustrated over here. You can also download the source code from GitHub as a gist. So you can search for Mickey Mouse animation. So for this animation, we are going to use only face animator and animate properties like offset and rotation. Let's begin with the upper body. We are going to use the face animator modifier. So let's add it here. With the face animator modifier, we need to specify some faces for the animation to go through. We can do this using an enum or using an array. If you have an animation involving more than two steps, the best way is to use an enum. But for this animation, we need only two steps. So let's use an array. So we want to specify the steps as false and true. Next, we have to specify what we want to animate and how we want to animate it. So here I will bring a closure. So for what to animate, that is the upper body. So we can say Mickey upper body. Then we specify how we want to animate it. Next, we bring the content we want to animate. That is this one. So I'll copy it here and paste over here. For the upper body, we will use only offset to create the animation. That is the Y offset. So we can use the animation variable we defined here. It's moving down up and use it along with ternary conditional operation. So let's paste it here and bring a question mark. For the true value, we want to set the offset to be minus 0.5. And the false value will be 1. So we now have a subtle movement of the upper body. Let me zoom in so that you see it well. Can see there is a subtle movement of the upper body. If you add the face animator modifier to animate a property, by default you get a repeating animation, but we can customize the animation by adding animation here. For this property, we will use the animation variable. Then we can choose a standard easing. Let's use ease in out without any duration. So this is how to create the upper body animation. Let's move on to the next by animating the skirt. For this, we will also use face animator. As you can see, this is almost the same as the previous animation without specifying the animation easing. So you can see the skirt is moving up and down as well using this Y offset. In the third step, we will animate the right shoe. So instead of using the Y offset in the previous animation, here we are using rotation effect to rotate the right shoe at an angle of minus 15 and plus 15. We also animate the anchor point or the center of gravity as well. So we are using animation to switch it between the bottom trailing and the top trailing. Let's move on to the shoe left. That also has a similar animation as the right shoe. But here, the animation is a little bit subtle. Next, we will animate the face. The face animation is also similar to the one we created previously. It is using the offset, that is the Y offset, to move the face up and down. Let's jump to the right eye. So that would also have this animation. For the right eye, we are using a scale effect, scaling the eye between 0 and 1. So it disappears and appears quickly. As you have noticed here, it is also using a custom timing curve. If you want to use a custom timing curve in your animation, you can go to the browser and search for easings.net. Over here, you can find so many custom easings. So the one I showed previously is using this kind of animation. So to use this in SwiftUI, you just need to copy only the cubic Bezier values and use it in the animation. Let's go to the left eye in the next. As you can see, the left eye animation is similar to the right eye animation, and it is also using a custom timing curve, but the values differ a little bit. Our next animation will be the tongue. For the tongue, we are using two scale animations. You can see here there is scale X and also scale Y. So this animates each coordinate separately, rather than animating X and Y together. For example, if you remove the X and Y and animate the coordinates together, we cannot create an effect like this. So let's leave it like that. Our last animation will be the hand left. So this also is having a rotation animation and using a custom timing curve. So if you need to animate an illustration similar to this, this is how you can use Face Animator in Swift UI to create the animation you want. Thanks for watching this video.